This video features a very special Asian-inspired setup of the Sylvanian Families Lakeside Lodge, released in the UK in 2002. Here is the front of the spacious house with the surrounding yard. The house is owned by the solitaire Siamese cats. I really like the French doors, the big balcony, and the open design on the bottom floor. The house features a really nice porch as well. Let's first take a look at the back of the house, nestled in the heart of nature. The house is set upon a calming stream I created out of craft paper. Endless mystery and adventure awaits those who follow the stream back to the forest. Here we have an ornamental dragon right next to a snail found on the rock. There's also a lovely statue of a fisherman. I created the rocks around the stream using Playmobil structures as well as rocks that I found outside of my house. And here we have Playmobil birds, ducks, turtle, and hedgehog as friends of nature. The white flower by the rocks is from the Sylvanian family's vintage country flower shop. Let's take a closer look at the lovely patio. The original house comes with this piece that could be slid out and you could create a porch, or it can be used as a storage compartment. I used the porch side of this piece and covered it with craft paper to make it look like patio pavers. And I added the flower box from the Grand Hotel in the front. The patio furniture is from Bramble's department store, and the ice creams are from the vintage brunch stand. There's a beautiful sitting garden on this side of the house, containing a tree planted long ago in veneration of the solitaire cat ancestors, and a place for contemplation, meditation, and solitude. I used rocks and pebbles about the tree in the garden, interspersed with little flowers from the critter collection. The beautiful stone fencing, benches, and the sundial are actually miniatures from the Limax collection. Fire is a symbol of ritual and purity in Japanese culture, and this flame is always kept lit. Here we have barrels of delicious seafood from the stream. On the other side of the house is a vegetable garden and an area by the stream to do laundry. Inside the house on the left is the kitchen, on the right is the entryway and study. Upstairs on the right is the family room, and to the left is the bedroom. So let's take a look inside. On this shelf in the entryway are books and antiques that Mr. Solitaire has collected from his travels around the world. Cozy little kitchen nook with a backdrop of a beautiful mural on the wall. A bag full of onions is always at hand. The beautiful mural on the kitchen wall depicts a figure in a basket being descended into a mystical chasm. The entryway has rugs that I copied from stickers from the Oak Hollow Treehouse. The solitaires are collectors of anthropomorphic artwork by the English artist Lewis Wayne. This lovely piece depicts two cats fencing. The mural of the tiger on the way up the stairs is something I drew to create a bookmark for my father. I thought it would be interesting to show the process. Here you could see it starting out with black and white and some of my colored pencil swatches on the side. I drew this by looking at a photo online. I will still turn this into a bookmark for my father, but I thought it would be perfect for this Asian-themed setup. Here next to the aquarium, we have a little bonsai tree from the Sylvanian Families Japanese Room set. The aquarium is so vibrant and colorful. There is a nice transition between the entryway and the kitchen where the critters can store their letters. The sitting area in the kitchen is from the Japanese room set. I love this long white cabinet, stove, and sink piece. It's from an older critter furniture set, and it looks really good in the old, larger houses. Another beautiful piece of artwork by Lewis Wayne. Mr. Solitaire is heading upstairs. Let's go with him. The beautiful gold screen dividing the living room from the bedroom is from Playmobil. This small window on the back wall was very plain, but I spruced it up with stickers from the dollar store to create an archaic frame and ribbon trim at the top. This cute floral pattern trash can is from the Japanese room set. The bedding and the ivory-colored furniture is also from the Japanese room set. The screen in the back is another critter accessory separating the bedroom from the washroom. Another beautiful piece by Lewis Wayne. The piece with the two red drawers is from the Japanese room set, and the red lamp, the white clock, and the green candlestick holder are from the interior shop. The back wall was really fun to do. I used flower stickers that I got from a dollar store to create extra Asian flair. Here, I've removed the screen divider to show you the vanity in the bathroom. Now we'll take a look at the front of the house. Just outside of the kitchen, we have a cute bench which has storage under the seating, as well as a box of sweet treats to enjoy and magazines. This antique-looking refrigerator is from the Urban Life series. The tidy critters are never without their cleaning supplies between the refrigerator and the sink over there. Now I think the Japanese are some of the masters at creating and collecting miniatures, and the solitaire cats are no different. So I took this little table from the Calico Critters Fashion Boutique, turned it upside down, and then filled it with a little bit of grass, a miniature windmill, and a miniature goat. It's a treasured display for all to enjoy. Let's peek into the bedroom through the balcony doors. Here we have an outfit from Ms. Solitaire that came with a Japanese room set hanging on the room divider. Peeking through the balcony door, Ms. Solitaire looks beautiful. The inviting porch is a nature lover's paradise. Ms. Solitaire enjoys reading from her book of magical tales with lemonade as a refreshment. I made the house-shaped paper lanterns as a modern take on a Chinese lantern. I took transparent paper in white and different colors for the roofs to cut out the shapes of the houses and then put them around lights to create the paper lanterns. Ms. Solitaire never ceases to be enchanted by the beautiful lighting. Ms. Solitaire enjoys conversing with the birds as Mr. Solitaire enjoys sharing his miniature collection with Mr. Merriweather. The men reminisce about their days of youth in the ancestor garden. Birds never fly away from the calming presence of Mr. Solitaire. Time to check the fish on the grill. Only phone calls from friends, no telemarketers in the land of critters. The children are never without wonder when watching the aquarium. They even named the fish Treasury and Jewelry. I got the beautiful kimonos from Kobe, Japan. Mr. Solitaire can't wait for a tasty meal. There's nothing like calming green tea. Ms. Solitaire is bustling around in the kitchen. Those critter sandwiches may be just too cute to eat. Everyone's looking forward to the fire festival this week. Mr. Solitaire is always so diligent to make sure there's enough oil to keep the flame on his fire burning. Ms. Solitaire often ends her evening with a game of solitaire. And Mr. Solitaire spends his evenings watching old music performances on TV. Tonight, he's enjoying old performances by Kyu Sakamoto. I hope you've enjoyed this setup, which was really fun to do, and I hope you liked one of my all-time favorite songs as the background, performed by Japanese artist Kyu Sakamoto, and was an international hit. Namida na koborete